YouTube, what's up? It's your boy Splash with another pickup video, you know. So what's been up, you know? Your boy just been chilling, you know. But not gonna ramble yet. Let's just get into the pickup. Two pickups, actually. New Nike Sportswear box. Y'all out them status for you. 616-773-100. Receipt. These just dropped on Friday. Some old school, you know. Got the white glove. Cocaine. Pure white, you know. Iconic gloves, you know. And that's kind of what, like, the majority of my cops been this year. Is, like, iconic stuff, you know. You know, retro Jordan-wise, those are always going to be, you know, on a pedestal or whatever. But, like, what's come out this year? Gloves come out. The Shaq Attacks, the Mutombos, Kamikazes, you know. Like I said, the LeBrons and the KDs and Kobe's, like, I do wear Kobe's, you know what I'm saying? I got, like, four pair of Kobe 8s. I didn't get any LeBron 10s, and I don't particularly like the LeBron 11. I think, I mean, it's just my personal opinion, I think the Zoom Soldier 7 looks better than the 11. Even though they look similar, I just, there's something about that Zoom Soldier that just looks better to me, you know, but I mean, a lot of people went in on the 11, you know. You know, the King, what is that? King's Pride or whatever colorway, and that Forging Iron one, preheat or whatever, $250, you know. I mean, teach his own, you know. I've kind of stayed out of that lane. I kind of stayed out of the retro lane, too, of Jordans a little bit. But those Gamma 12s, those are going to be a problem. That was pretty dope. But, yeah. You know. Gloves. You know. Got that OG colorway. Green inside. Flight on the back. But, yeah, like I said, majority of my cops have been stuff like that. Things I relate to. I mean, like, the younger generation that's coming up now, they're going to relate to LeBrons and Kobe's and KD's. You know what I'm saying? Like, how older heads like myself would relate to, let's be like Grant Hills or the gloves or the Mutombos, you know, the Iversons, you know. So, like I said, teach his own, you know, it's all sneakers. But, you got the cocaine white, as I like to call them, gloves. Zip these back up, you know. Just, this is one of my favorite silhouettes of a shoe ever, especially the black one. You know, I did cop the black one. Yeah, so, like I said, the gloves. And I got another pickup. I'm gonna actually show you something that isn't DS. I DS'd them last night. I think it's gonna be one of those weeks, like, high school basketball starts up. I got two nephews to start for our hometown team. So, we got Thanksgiving tournament all week. I got a game, like, every day this week. So, I just thinking about UNDS or something every day. I think I have, like 8 pair of shoes I haven't worn yet. So, I can knock 5 of them out. So, I'll just call it UNDS week. But I started early last night because I had to go to a benefit. A co-worker of mine. She doesn't have breast cancer, but she has the trait, the gene or whatever that's for it, and like her cousin had it, so she's getting her breast removed just because. So, like I said, I'm gonna DS something. I didn't wear them like this, but I laced them up. Lady fives, you know. Like I said, they aren't DS. I DS'd them last night. Wore them out. Had the white laces in them, you know. These pretty tough though, you know, that tumble leather and the round laces that it came with. I'll show you the other shoe. Have you seen the ladies like this though? Tell me which one's hotter, the yellow or the blue. You know. Second pickup. If you're not familiar with the box, I apologize. You know everything about me was not about the swoosh and the jump, man. But like I said, I got something classic. Got the Converse, Arrow Jam, the Grandmamas, the Larry Johnson, whatever you want to call them. I got them. You know. If you're my age, you know all about these. You know about the Grandmama campaign and, you know. This is kind of like that lace shroud, like the Jordan 8s a little bit. You know. Just, you know, something I wanted. I seen it was coming out just like out of the blue. Made a couple phone calls to a couple people, and then I seen like they sold out online, and you know, got on eBay, and you already know. We should be tired of resellers, but we still have to deal with them. So I sat out for like a week, and was over in the Lou, St. Louis. You know, like I said, that's just going into the city. That's less than an hour, you know. So went to Galleria. The boys are sitting up in Champs. They were sitting on eBay for like $250, and you know all this other stuff. Cause you know, you attach limited, the word limited or quick strike to anything, or it's only going to be at Foot Locker, or it's only going to be at Champs, or it's only going to be here. That's a reseller's dream, you know. Like I said, I walked into Champs. They had a display on them. I don't know if they had a restock. I mean, that's neither here nor there. Copped them for retail. I walked out, you know. Went and met a couple of my butts, a couple of my friends. Tried to go holler at Horse Eddie. That was Friday. Yeah, it was Friday. He was off. But what is up with all the ex-Prime Soul workers in Foot Locker now? I thought I was in the wrong store at first. Shout out to Horse Eddie. Shout out to Tez. Can't remember my other dude's name. And, you know, of course, a cop wouldn't be a cop if I didn't freak it my own way, you know, with the laces, you know. I've always been, like, big in the laces on shoes that drop because, like, you might be out the same time. Of course, you ain't going to have on the same fit or nothing, but, you know, you might have on the same shoes. You know what I'm saying? I feel like my laces is going to make my shoe look different from yours. So, that's right. I've always been like that. So, yep. Converse Aero Jam. Something classic. And that's pretty much all 2013 been for me. Top and classic joints. You know, gloves, Gary Payton, Larry Johnson. Oh, bring up another point. I mean, it's not even a point. Hey, attending my first little sneaker show. What day was it? It's like a month ago. It was the same day. It was the same day these released, the Laneys. It was the same day. It's over in Maryland Heights, you know. Me and my boy Rowdy went over there, you know, check it out or whatever, you know. How the hell for stay, you know. Kid Crazy, you know who he is, you know. Chopped it up with a couple of people like I hadn't seen in a while. Because, like, I've been, like, staying away from releases, so I'm not in lines or, you know what I'm saying, at the store on release day. And a couple other people that I see in line, you know, was on the same stuff. But St. Louis right now might be hype beast capital of the world. And, you know, thing what I wanted to see, but they trying, so I can't knock the Lou. I mean, like, I'm basically in that area, you know what I'm saying? you know. And like I said, if they do another show, like me and my buddy Rowdy was talking about even like setting up a table, cause like you talk about Nike Air on the back of this, he has it. Like, you know, I was never like a hoarder of shoes per se, and like I teach, so I would always like give the old stuff away. You know what I'm saying? So like, as far as OG stuff, like I don't have too much of it left. Couple pairs or whatever, but he has it all. So we was just talking about setting up a table with his OG stuff, and then I'm have a table like, you know, stuff like this, you know, stuff that like everybody doesn't see every day. And like that's what we went over there expecting. Like, we wanted to see some OG stuff, or we wanted to see something that wasn't like in rotation. Like, everybody had these on, or they had on the 12-4s, you know. But you could tell, like, as you walked through a couple times, you could tell who the resellers were, you could tell who the hype beast was, you can tell who the OG collectors was, and this, that, and third, because it kind of like mingled to each other. But the conversations was cool, you know what I'm saying? There's a couple people there had some serious stuff. But, you know, like, I wore the CB34s, the Godzillas, and boy Rowdy had on the Jordan 20s, the West Coast edition with the Carolina on it. You know what I'm saying? That's what I was trying to see. I was trying to see something that ain't in rotation, you know. And like, somebody had on the 19s, white and gray joints. Those was tough, you know. Of course, like Helpstead had on the Easy 2s. Somebody came in with the Easy 1s. Like my boy had on the Kobe 6 Barcelonas. You know, that was tough. But, you know, it was too much of this for me. You know, I'm like I said, I don't hate Jordans whatsoever. I got a lot of Jordans. It's just like, I want to see something like, oh, man, what, you know. Like, I saw the MVP, I saw the championship LeBrons, the MVP LeBrons. What else? Like I said, the Heat was, and like I said, Heat is all of state of mind anyway, so. It was just like, I was disappointed because of what I wanted to see. But they do another show, I'll probably attend. But like I said, that's all I got today. Lanes. Grandmamas. GPs. And with that said, it's your boy Splash. I'm about to sign out. Keep on saying, I'm going to do a shout out video. Man, shout out to, just go off the top of the dome. Shout out to Mike Ferb. Shout out to DJ Drama 5. Shout out to Brad MI. Amesel 25. J Star. Hell of a State. Horse Eddie. Fresh Prince of Jordans. You see what I'm saying? That's why I don't do it off the top of my head. Like I said, it's your boy Splash. I'm about to sign out. Peace.